Hey guys, I am at Fort Concho in San Angelo, Texas. This is an old cavalry fort that was built back in the 1860s to protect settlers that were in the region from Indians and Mexican bandits and armies and whatnot. But the real reason I'm here, because when I was growing up, I loved the movies, The Apple Dumpling Gang, and in The Apple Dumpling Gang Rides Again, this is the fort that Don Knotts and Tim Conway burnt to the ground. And I love that movie. It was not filmed here. They did not actually burn it to the ground. It was fictitious. It's actually really neat. They've still got most of the original buildings. This was actually a pretty large fort. It had about a 400 or 500 man army in it, cavalry. It's got some, that tree I'll bet has been here since it was new. That's pretty neat. That's an old tree. And you can come tour them today. They have a museum. I don't know their hours. You will have to Google that. But all the buildings are really in fantastic shape. They've obviously been rehabbed a little bit and obviously kept up with, but most of the original look is still intact and there, and it's pretty cool. It's definitely a piece of the American West that is neat to be able to still see and keep around. Yeah, if these walls could talk. This may be one of the buildings that the Apple Dumpling Gang burned down. But it is only ruins left of it. Kind of shows you the way they used to construct things. You can still see a lot of the, what I would imagine, floorboards and joists would be put into the walls. No doubt a door, stuff like that. Another fun fact about Fort Concho is Pecos Bill used to be one of the commanders here, and the Buffalo soldiers would run out of here a lot. if you are familiar with their history in the American West. A lot of old, creepy ruin. Oh, yep.
Hey there, pilgrim.
I'm Chris Bauer, and I am an art slinger. I travel around the U.S. selling artwork at comic and anime conventions. And while I'm there, I like to check out cool sights, eat great food, and see all the places my favorite movies and TV shows are made. Welcome to Sets, Streets, and Eats. I've been going to conventions or shows since I was a kid. I bring that up because we're in this coliseum, and I also grew up going to swap meets in Michigan, flea markets, and a lot of those were in fairgrounds or coliseums like this. So there's a lot of nostalgia built into these conventions for me when they're like this. Looks amazing, man. Thank you. Toys! So many toys. Swords. There's always cool weaponry at all of these shows. Doctor Strange's necklace with Infinity Stone. Any type of wand you can imagine from Harry Potter. Lots of new jewelry. All very cool. Looks like cups made of horns. Corsets and skirts. All kinds of bags and plushies. Backpacks.
Nice.
So if you're looking for a lunch place in San Angelo, you can come here to Gorilla Burger. It's pronounced Gorilla Burger. Their logo is a gorilla, but it's spelled Grill A Burger. So we ordered our food. I got the Western Burger. So this place is got a cute little 50s vibe to it. Comes highly recommended by the internet, by the way. They have two locations here in San Angelo. They've been around for a while, and apparently their burgers are quite tasty. Those onion rings are good. So this has grilled jalapenos, onion rings, lettuce, tomato, regular toppings, barbecue sauce. Patty's super juicy. Yeah, this is a really good burger. Yeah, it totally does. Yeah. So I'll have to look it up, but I don't believe Giant was filmed here. But it was probably set near here. I guess it had to be filmed somewhere around here, but I'll definitely look that up. But there is a lot of references to Giant starring James Dean in this alley. So it obviously has some meaning locally. It's kind of cool. This is basically just literally an alley that I assume there's stuff in these buildings. But they just kind of let artists come in and do whatever they want. Yeah, this would be like a great place to put patio tables or have a band. Yeah. Summer night. That's kind of neat. When you get close up, it's actually all cowboys and Indian figures. That's really neat. Which is basically how the West was won, as they say. So next to each piece here in the alley, they have a little scan code that you can learn about the artist, and it links to information on the piece and in progress videos. It's pretty neat. Not the jail. At least it's air conditioned. Oh, this is fun. You can see yourself in jail. Oh no. So, as you can probably tell, hasn't been a very greatly attended show. I'd say the crowd is pretty light, but, you know, we are in a different time than normal. I heard someone say they had about 800 to 900 pre-sales, but that seems a little high given the crowd that I've seen. But it could be. I really don't know. I know they had Jason David Frank, who is the Green Power Ranger. He was here yesterday, and they had his booth out by the front of the, not even in the hall, but by the front, basically, entrance. And I know that line was pretty long, but if people were coming just for an autograph, then some of them may not have even come in to the, you know, to the actual hall. I am definitely very appreciative of shows that still happen, even though it's we're in the middle of the time we're in. So I definitely wanted to come out and support it, and I definitely don't regret coming, but that might be one I might skip in the future, or I might come back. You never know. At full strength, this might be a really good show. I don't know what kind of crowd they get normally. I believe this is a 4 or 5 year old show convention. Sorry, I say show a lot, just in case you don't know. I'm always talking about convention.
Welcome to the Angry Cactus.
Timbo's back. He's got his Set Streets and Needs mask on. Why don't you comment below and ask how you can get one of those?
So we are at the Angry Cactus, right here downtown San Angelo, Texas. This place comes highly recommended via locals and the internet. It's got American food, and they have a what they call a Texican, which is basically their Tex-Mex also. But they've got a couple of dishes that they're kind of known for, and we're going to try them out.
Tim got some ciders to try. He's very picky with his ciders. Doesn't normally say that. Usually he goes, ew.
Is to scan this and just look at it on your phone. So Tim's gonna check this out. He's gonna find that menu. And bada boom, bada bing, there it is. And you just look at your own phone. Waste not, want not.
I like it.
Yeah, and they can change the menu all the time. They can change it without...
That's very true.
Or change a physical menu.
Which is expensive.
They can use chefs, deal all the days kind of stuff more often.
Yeah, I think that that should definitely catch on. So we're at dinner with Eric, Timbo, John and Olivia, and of course, moi. Tonight's dinner was a special one because Tim invited our friend John Swasey. John brought his daughter Olivia and his friend Eric Vale. All three of them are voice actors on an assortment of anime series for companies like Funimation, Crunchyroll, and many others. These companies license anime shows from Japan and dub them with English-speaking actors.
Kurogiri, you fool.
Eric's quite well known for major characters from Dragon Ball Z, One Piece, My Hero Academia, and many others.
Hollow cheeks and sunken eyes, to think that you're their greatest hero.
John's known for characters from Full Metal Alchemist, Oren Host Club, My Hero Academia as well, and tons more. Both these guys have been in the business for over 20 years. Olivia has only been in the business a short time, but has already voiced over a dozen characters on shows like Seven Seeds and Assassin's Pride. Anime has enjoyed a major pop culture boom over the last decade and has given the American voice actors a large fan base that attend conventions and purchase autographs and photos from them. They had great stories from many of their past convention appearances, and I enjoyed hearing them while we ate this amazing food. We started with bacon-wrapped shrimp and a new one for me, bacon-wrapped quail breast.
For that.
But then
no, it's okay. It's okay.
It never freaking ends.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't. So,
at least on Instagram,
the bacon is definitely crisper.
Follow people that eat the picture.
I don't read it. No.
But I'm both really tasty.
Like, but I'm on.
Tangy, ketchup-y kind
of thing. Fuck, that's awesome.
Bacon wrap quail.
It's juicy. Tasty. We're still just tasting the bacon.
There's the quail.
Yeah.
And that was just unexpected money.
You know, he was
you're
smart.
I just
he took 15% of the merchandise sales. For
and do what you need
a little
to do.
Dive shot here. Oh,
they actually
yeah.
did rice and beans. Not rice and beans, but rice and beans.
I thought it was rice and beans and beans.
It's rice and beans.
Just kind of mix them together.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Call that little dolly
I've never
shot
seen
here.
That
oh, yeah.
Right. First, before we eat, let's cheers. This is a great. Glad to be out with you guys. Glad
cheers.
You.
Good times, everybody.
There we go, guys.
Tomorrow's halfway decent.
Wonderful.
I'll go home happy and healthy.
All right. Let's do this.
Well.
The
reason that's not happening
here
is there's no space for it. It's
unbelievable.
That was delicious.
That was very tasty. And I'm now going to order the bananas Foster for dessert. Because it looks awesome.
Oh, hello.
All right,
I got
a martini coming?
I got one for you. And so she's like, and
throw one open with a loud thud.
There is 300 people in this room.
No.
There's
look at that.
No.
Oh
Oh man, dude, this is amazing.
You know what? I'm gonna
maybe
take
one.
I'm telling you.
I'm gonna take one banana.
Yeah. Do it.
I am not trying it. 3 seconds later.
Dinner was fantastic. I can't recommend the Angry Cactus enough. We all really enjoyed it.
Walking home late at night, maybe 2:30. A little drunk, but I'm alright, 'cause I've been hanging.
It's Sunday, kind of winding down. It's really only midday, but the crowd has been very, very light today, especially. They don't really have a big name celebrity draw today. Jason David Frank was only here for one day, so a lot of people didn't return for the second day, and which is totally understandable. That about wraps it up for me here at San Angelo Comic Con, and I hope you enjoyed. I got to see only just a teeny bit of the city, but I did get to eat some really, really good food, and I know that this city's got a ton of really cool stuff like art and art museums and art galleries that I didn't get to see at all. And just based on the art that's sitting around the city, I would imagine those art galleries and museums are probably pretty good. And of course, Fort Concho, I kind of wish it was open once I got there to kind of look at it. I bet that's a pretty cool tour. I bet they have a lot of really great stories to tell on the tour. So I would definitely recommend that, because I will, if I come back here, I will definitely be trying to do that tour. Got kind of a long drive home, so I'm probably gonna start packing up and get on out of here. So I appreciate you watching Set Streets and Eats, and we'll see you on down the road. Bye now.